Resistance is asking for our help in extracting a VIP who had been providing reconnaissance data in this area. We've got the coordinates, but it's likely we'll have to clear out a contingent of hostile forces to make this work.
Yes, hello and welcome back to some more Gem Lore of the Chosen. We're completing, hopefully completing,
secure the VIP and proceed first to the evac mission. Volume for extraction. Advent already knows we're here, so your position isn't concealed for the extraction.
This had a very large map, Sidrap, which I'm like, that doesn't seem large at all. That's like the building is already starting here where our evac is on. So that's a little bit concerning. So the fact that we have 10 to 12 enemies in that area. And as always, our shinobi is in a position where they can't move.
Oblivion awaits.
You can't sneak through there. It's always the damn Templar that's in the way. Let's stop playing the Templar.
Fine.
Mi avvicino alle coordinate. Civilians. I guess I don't have concealment anyway on the rest of the squad, so why care about civilians? Do I really move here on the edge of the map, or do I start moving a little bit to the center? I don't know. I think I'll stay on the edge.
Together, we are strong.
On the edge.
I got you back.
No problem, boss.
On Overwatch.
Mi muovo all'istante.
What a civilian minefield. If that was a lip 3, then half of those would be faceless, but on a lip 2, they shouldn't be.
Affirmativo, mi muovo.
Nothing, huh?
It is destined.
It's strange. Do I dare dashing?
Are we moving out or making love?
That's the question here, isn't it?
Seems doable.
We're gonna have reinforcements at some point, so you can't just play enemy within and blue move creep up.
The time for contemplation has passed.
Scanning.
Si muove qualcosa.
These mutants seem a little more agile than the ones we fought in the past. It looks like they're still
serving
as the
front
line,
though.
So that's a group and a half.
I mean, I'm fairly close.
Go, go, go!
Let's get you in there. Mutant Beleaguer. I mean, you saw the two sectoids in the back, so that's nothing. I need to explain. They like to go on Overwatch, and they have this Russian roulette ability. If they miss the short run on Overwatch, they take another shot, and another, until they run out of ammo or they hit. So even with lightning reflexes, you're gonna have a bit of a hard time. Well, unless you just clear the Overwatch with damage. Or suppression, or whatever else you want to do. They don't have counterattack melee, I think. Fairly certain.
Ordine ricevuto. Mi muovo.
Also I did hear some sounds from this direction. So I didn't hear this group. I heard something over there. There's also, by the way, they're all in cover technically. So we're not gonna have great sniping shots here. Well, we kind of do, but not really. Good chance. Did I already overwatch you? No.
I get it, okay?
This civilian yelling? I don't think it put them on alert, okay.
Hey, inspection time!
Together, we are too close. Put you on overwatch.
Stand up, everyone!
Massima attenzione.
Put you here.
I'm going. Moving to overwatch.
And the big question is, what do we do with our sniper? Could do like a lead the target. Tombiliga. So I get an overwatch shot on him. Now here's a big question. Shouldn't I, since I was using this whole watchful eye, right? I was using it incorrectly, or rather I was trying to use it from concealment, but it doesn't break concealment, but you're not gonna take shot. Lead the target does, but I didn't have that. But now I could just, this one's mine, the beleaguer. I get a free overwatch shot on him due to watchful eye. And I can lead the target, the beleaguer. And that should trigger two overwatches here.
A waste of time.
One of those missed. Just like this shot did.
I do not believe this.
Right on the margins.
He hit. No idea where exactly that sector it went. Really don't know why that sector went. You don't have a shot there. Don't have counterattack. They do have a lot of armor, holy crap. I don't think I have any other way to shred armor. Got one AP grenade here. Okay. No! That was a misclick. What a terrible misclick. Okay. Just suppress you. Yes, you have cutthroat and you ignore armor. Right, here's what we're gonna do. Gonna get a nice little pillar over here. Lovely little villa.
Beccata. Contatto visivo con truppe Advent.
What? Oh, it's not the contactor I wanted to have here. Oh, what's this then? Targeting deception. Oh, deception? Oh no, it's deception or distraction. A rocketeer, assault trooper. Man, if I still had pillar, I would just block that window. Surprised that this got activated, but not when we ran the Templar over here. So that's all not so great. Build the assault trooper with Volt. I think we can just command and Volt in there. So let's do this. That's one for all. Eight protocol here. Over there. It a volt does 4 to 7. Got the sectoid, got the assault trooper. This guy's on 1 HP and we destroyed half the wall there for some reason, which gives you a shot on the rocketeer. Wait, that went better than expected. Who needs a storm rider?
What?
Missed, but he's just gonna watch, right? Okay. Ankle shot is annoying, obviously, because that reduces our mobility. Although am I hit? No. It would reduce our mobility if we were hit, but he didn't hit. Okay. We had 7 enemies out of potential 10 to 12. Probably need to suppress that guy again to get rid of his Overwatch.
That's what I'm talking about.
Eat it. So I know the sorcerer is somewhere in here. Just not sure if we can't just ignore him. This guy, maybe kill the zombie. Probably kill this guy with the tent right here. But you know what? Let's do that first. On Overwatch.
Danger lurks here.
Hell. More bad guys. Another duelist. Cryo priest and a purifier. All pretty far away. So, you're gonna finish up this.
That's right enough.
So that we can power up again. Okay, cool. I thought you could attack the zombie from here, but you have to go here, half cover. That's 75 aim, so that's not really where I want to be. Wanna tank the zombie with combatus.
In movimento. Obiettivo ottenuto.
Sure, what? Can you do other stuff? You can do insanity on me, which would disable my combatus. Closer to the zombie than Natalie here. Yeah. Like this thing, 4 to 7 damage is actually a lot. I'm kind of concerned that if he goes for the Templar, that might be a bad thing. Shooting at Andy, which is not very nice, but we can deal a little with that. And the zombie is confused about life. Alright, cool. Let me snipe. Let's snipe that guy. Sure, let's give it a shot. That sounded like a hit for 2 damage. The duelist. Okay. I'm very much concerned about the purifier. I can never remember what the range is for Volt to jump to another target. Like, if I Volt that guy, will it jump to this? I think they might all be perfectly spaced. I'm not getting any jumps. getting a suppression on the priest end either. I think I need to center it on the duelist to make sure he's dead.
Fire in the hole!
Just Overwatch also removed the guy. How am I? This is the one square where I see the dude there. Right, time for a big gamble. So if that goes down, goes south, we teamwork you out of there and then reconsider our options. I think we're just gonna move out into the open.
We need to stick together.
And chain shot this guy.
Negative.
All right. Did I give you frost immunity? Yes.
Do you really need this?
You kill this guy. Zombie here. This guy dies. Oh, I remembered correctly. At least us with a purifier.
Our faith will prevail.
Which we're just gonna conduit. Probably should have moved away. I mean, I'm combatus tanking the Risen here, but if he comes, he could also come over there. There's no guarantee that he goes in here. A little bit on the risky side. Didn't realize the Void Conduit would just outright kill the guy.
Sono troppo vicino al fuoco.
Refocus.
Triumph through sacrifice.
Mi sto muovendo.
That's a free loot.
Pacco bersaglio ottenuto. Bersaglio nemico a terra.
Seems doable.
There could be more enemies on the map. I think we're just only at 10 kills.
I'm on my way. We have work
two
to do.
More. Also, we got reinforcements coming in soonish. I never activated the berserk thing. I'm never sure, like, if I don't want to waste it, right?
Yes.
I probably should have activated it at some point. That was nothing for the long term. Okay. No enemy turns. Let's just dash.
Move it up!
Corro!
Don't fall behind!
Our paths shall be one.
Make sure you're somewhere where you can blue move into the zone, and we can Oscar Mike to get our sniper to catch up.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Should be safe to get you out of here already.
Roger that!
I can handle that.
Together, we are strong.
And then Oscar Mike was enough to get you in there. Didn't check if you could have made it anyway, but... Let's evac. Let's go. Lip 2 done.
This is Firebrand. VIP is secure.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Took 1 point of damage, which should be mitigated by Field Surgeon if I have that already. I'm fairly certain Andy has that, right? Right.
And despite the destruction left in their wake, XCOM refuses to let go of the ways of the old world. They will continue their wanton and reckless crimes until the entire world burns around them. We are grateful to the Elders for their support.
The aliens are probably still wondering what hit them. Let's keep it up,
Commander. Yes, no wound timers. Alright, what's next here? Repost. Prime weapon to counter enemy attacks that will miss a grace. Or our guard is active. So it's a little bit like combatives, except you don't get the guaranteed first counterattack. Ice Dragon Breath. We frost on a confront user. What time cooldown? Each additional Dragon Breath learned reduces shed cooldown by one. So about those additional Dragon Breaths that I can learn. Well, I guess it's gore. Killing enemies has a chance to panic some of the nearby organic enemies. Alright. I think I reread through this tooltip already with the exact... It's like an exact calculation what the panic chance is. And nowhere does it explain what does count as nearby. But you know, I'm taking the little victories here. I feel like this talking about, oh, you can learn more Dragon Breaths and get the cooldown reduced, and then there not being any other Dragon Breaths that I can see. I'm very disappointed. I guess maybe in the XCOM roll you can roll more Dagon Breath. Alright, let's get Goa. You're gonna get Trojan. Think. So healing is nice, but never really sold on it. Scanning protocol has been really, really buffed. It's a free action now and has more charges and everything. Gets bonus charges with improved equipments. Even that is now in the tooltip. If specialist implant Haven Advisor, still a chance of recruiting new faces rebels. But Chojin just buys you, well, it can kill drones outright in the early game, and it buys you an extra turn when dealing with robotics, so I think it's gotta be Chojin. I'm not sure if I would like Templar, Storm Rider, Teamwork. Then again, you have super high mobility. So all those situations where you're already in blue move range of the enemies, you could just Teamwork to him and then still do your attack. And I think there wasn't there some shenanigans if you teleport to your bondmate? I'll have to think about this. First thing, we're gonna take a look at the combat engineer we just got. Which I think is our very first one, yes. So combat engineer, shotgun, grenade launcher. I'm fairly certain they can equip regular rifles, submachine guns, yeah, that's all good. They can equip rocket launchers. So that's an alternative. So a little bit of flexibility. So what I've liked to do in my previous campaign, or in my Twitch campaign, was to go for, since you start with smoke and mirrors, right? Free smoke grenade and basically having rapid deployment for your smokes. Getting combat drugs gives 20 aim to all targets that are in the smoke cloud when you deploy the grenade. And they basically play them a little bit as a support grenadier officer. Now, let's see, is there anything that makes me reconsider that? You have fairly high aim and fairly high mobility, which seems nuts. Where... what shop did you rob to get those stats? So you can certainly... turn them into a shotgunner, right? You've got an early running gun here. You get precision shot. With shotgun finesse, you get additional crit free mobility. Put you at 19, so 16 with equipment. You got hunter's instincts. For more damage on a flank shot. You got Slugshot here. Like, I know I like to rip on Slugshot on assaults because it's against lightning reflexes, but on its own, it's actually a good perk. If you're not giving up anything, well, giving up 10 AP, I guess. Priority target. So that's 10, 30 crit against targets next to you. This is okay, forget about tactical sense, but the rest is all worth picking up. This is a tough decision. Because as much as I liked combat drugs and the whole support grenadier approach, it didn't really have much going for it outside of combat drugs. Like, yeah, you threw the smoke grenade, and then everybody else was being awesome. Giving 20 aim to everybody is really good, though. Hard to give up. Gunshots against mechanical units have additional aim and shred up to 3 armor. This is... Okay, so aggression. It can be another 30 crit. And then slam fire. Now if you get a critical hit, your actions are refunded. Screw it. We're going offensive. We have two dragoons and two specialists that are going support the officer, right? Yeah. So combat drugs great and all, but why make your whole squad better than when you yourself can be awesome? Wait. So that puts us at Lib 2 here. So we can find Lib 3 now. When we get that, we find the network tower. When we get that, we get a free network tower here and can make contact cheaper to adjacent regions. Alternatively, if we pick up this, then this here goes down to 100. Which is good, but first things first. This supply raid. Raid an adventurine with a squad of 4. What was I thinking? I guess Mech Sniper has to carry, and I hope we can do that. But we'll do that in the next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time.